The US Army recently conducted tests and gathered feedback from soldiers regarding an upcoming aerial jamming system, and the initial responses have been favorable, according to a procurement official. Just over a month after expressing concerns about the gaps in the US military's electronic warfare capabilities, Army Undersecretary Gabe Camarillo announced that the Army's leading initiatives to enhance jamming and sensing capabilities is demonstrating potential. The Multifunction Electronic Warfare Air Large MFEW-AL is part of the Army's renewed focus on advanced electronic warfare technologies following a period of neglect. Lockheed Martin is leading the development of this self-contained pod, which was originally designed to be mounted on an MQ-1C Gray Eagle drone produced by General Atomics. However, there are now discussions about its broader applications. A few days ago, the US Army showcased the MFEW-AL pod in Aberdeen, Maryland. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Multifunction Electronic Warfare Air Large MFEW-AL pod could help the US dominate the EW spectrum. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. A 256-bit encryption keeps your online data safe, even on public Wi-Fi, and its threat protection system helps shield against malware and cyber threat. NordVPN application is available for Windows, macOS, iOS, Android, Linux, and even Android TV, and also encrypted proxy extensions for Chrome, Firefox, and Edge. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Electronic warfare, or EW, stands as one of the most crucial and technologically demanding elements of contemporary military operations. It encompasses a wide range of activities and technologies aimed at denying, disrupting, or exploiting the use of electromagnetic spectrum (EMS) by adversaries. In the modern battlefield, where information and communication systems play a pivotal role, EW capabilities have become essential for maintaining a competitive edge. It involves both defensive measures to protect friendly forces from electronic threats and offensive operations to neutralize or exploit the enemy's electronic systems. MFEW-AL pod is being seen as a key asset in this arena. The MFEW-AL has the capability to generate a real-time, comprehensive view of the electromagnetic spectrum in any area it traverses. Every electronic device using wireless, cellular, or mobile technology emits electromagnetic waves that are imperceptible to the human eye, but detectable by systems like MFEW-AL. MFEW-AL can detect all electronic devices and focus on specific ones of interest. The MFEW-AL is the U.S. Army's sole program officially designated to offer tactical commanders an extensive situational awareness and offensive electronic warfare (EW) capability that leverages the electromagnetic spectrum to secure an advantage over adversaries. MFEW-AL detects and shoots the furthest of all Army EW systems and is a focus for U.S. Army's modernization endeavors. Colonel Kevin Finch, a former project manager for EW&C, said in an interview from 2019, "You have 5 senses. All those senses perceive certain types of information, sight, sound, and so on. The EMS requires a 6th sense, since it's all around you and you can't perceive it. giving that sixth sense to the commander in field, the commander at higher echelons? That's a core goal with many of our programs, the MFEW-AL in particular. The testing of MFEW-AL began in January of 2020. In August 2021, during the U.S. Indo-Pacific Command's Exercise Forager 21, which aimed to test and refine multi-domain operational capabilities, the MFEW-AL showcased its electronic warfare capabilities consistently at extended ranges, surpassing the initial program requirements significantly. Originally designed to be affixed to an MQ-1C Grey Eagle drone, the Lockheed Martin-manufactured, self-contained pod is now under consideration for deployment on various other platforms. The U.S. Air Force has expressed interest in integrating it into an A-10 attack aircraft, and there are plans to conduct tests with the High Accuracy Detection and Exploitation System, a jet primarily configured for intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions. Officials have suggested that it should work if power and Ethernet ports are available. William Utroska, a leader at the Program Executive Office for Intelligence, Electronic Warfare, and Sensors, has stated, as reported in C4ISRNet.com, "We want to be platform agnostic. For other platforms, we can provide a smaller form factor if there's a requirement. We're working with the future Vertical Lift Cross-Functional Team because they have EW requirements and they know we've already done a lot of the work up front." Camarillo said he saw one of the prototypes in the field, courtesy of PEO, IEW&S, and liked its open-ended approach. "I think that's one area where the Army is heading in the right direction. It's giving us the ability to not just look at sensor payloads and EW payloads, but how they fit in certain components, how we can plug and play over time, to give us an opportunity to do that tech insertion, and to stay ahead of what the threat might be, and also have the latest generation capabilities." As the Pentagon readies itself for the possibility of conflict with Russia or China, the U.S. Army and other branches are shifting their focus back to electronic warfare. In a potential conflict, control of the electromagnetic spectrum becomes a critical battleground, and recent events, such as the constant targeting of communications and networks in the Ukraine conflict, have heightened the sense of urgency among U.S. officials. This competition is growing in significance as increasingly advanced technologies find their way onto the battlefield, and troops are making efforts to reduce their signatures to evade detection. Camarillo told reporters August 23rd, "What concerned me always is that we've got to keep pace with the threat over time. I'm really impressed with the MFEW program that the Army has, its different configurations, and where it's going. In this situation, MFEW-AL is set to play a crucial role."
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.